95% of everyone living in Minnesota's Olmsted County have given permission for their medical records to be used for research. Creating the Rochester Epidemiology Project, a medical research resource known and respected by researchers around the world and cited in over 2,800 scientific studies to date.
But we're the only place in the United States that can say we truly have population-based data.
The Rochester Epidemiology Project is important because it allows us today to answer questions in medicine that you would not be able to answer anywhere else.
As people access medical care, their confidential records documenting medical diagnoses, laboratory tests, and drug prescriptions are created and then maintained for future continuity of care. These data also can be used for research. The REP began with the collaboration between Mayo Clinic and Olmsted Medical Center in 1966. It has grown to become a cooperative initiative by many healthcare providers and dental practices. It collects, archives, and links this medical information from all providers in Olmsted County for the nearly 150,000 people living here, allowing researchers to study health and illnesses in this group. So we, as a community of people living within a relatively isolated geographic area, can make contributions to medical research by simply allowing access to our medical records for study. Patients accessing medical care in Olmsted County are given the opportunity to authorize their records to be used in research. 95% of those asked have agreed to sign this research authorization, but their decision to sign or refuse is honored. Today, most REP medical records are available to qualified researchers electronically. In the REP, approved medical records from different healthcare providers are collected, organized, and linked. All records of a specific person are grouped and stored by the person's name and dates when care was provided. These data are kept confidential with strict security safeguards. Authorized researchers work with REP staff to plan and conduct their studies. They're trained on how to access data. Then they retrieve and review records and conduct and publish their study. These studies inform medical knowledge and practice, and changes in medical practice are reflected in future medical records. The importance of the REP on medical research is large.
So in almost every field, be it the brain with dementia, Parkinson's disease, multiple sclerosis, epilepsy.
There's an asthma study going on right now.
Being cardiovascular disease with myocardial infarction, congestive heart failure, arrhythmias.
We've looked at things like postpartum depression.
You name it, it's probably been looked at in the Rochester Epi Project.
It's a gigantic contribution to medicine.
The REP is expanding the resources from Olmsted County, Minnesota, to 27 counties in a region that extends across southeastern Minnesota and west-central Wisconsin, with records for over 1 million people. The Rochester Epidemiology Project. Because almost all of us want to help.
My personal data is a small piece in this big puzzle, but without that small piece, you can't finish the puzzle. I hope that the discoveries that are made, help not only me, but my kids, generations to come.